Okay, so let's start today class. In the previous class, we have discussed the property of the Fourier transform. Okay, that means linearity property we have already discussed in the previous class. Today we are going to discuss another property of the Fourier transform, that means time shifting property. Okay, so just try to see what is the time shifting property of the Fourier transform. So just first of all, we share the screen and then we will continue our discussion. Okay, so in the previous class, we already seen that the Fourier transform of the linear property. In linear property, that means two separate signal, if represented by x1 omega and x2 omega in Fourier transform, then the a1 x1 t a plus a2 x2 t as the Fourier transform of x a1 x1 plus a1 x1 omega plus a2 x2 omega. Now we just try to see the time shifting property of the Fourier transform. Okay, so let's try to see here time shifting property of the Fourier transform. Okay. Time shifting property of Fourier transform. Fourier transform. So just try to see what is this property. If any signal we shift by time t naught, okay. So original signal is represented by time domain in xt, and if this signal shifted by some time constant, that means represented by t0, in place of t0, maybe whatever the constant value, either 3, 4, 5, whatever you maybe want. So t0 is your time constant from which we shift the original signal. Okay. So according to this property, we can say that if xt has the Fourier transform x omega, then Fourier transform of xt minus t0 is equal to, we can write e to the power minus j omega t0 plus, t0 into x omega. Okay. So if any signal, signal xt has the Fourier transform x omega, if any signal xt has the Fourier transform presented by x omega, so signal xt has the Fourier transform equal to x omega. So Fourier transform represented by capital X and time domain signal represented by small x. Okay. So x omega so time shifting property state that time shifting property state that if original signal XT shifted by some time constant that is represented by T naught. So XT minus T naught has a Fourier transform e to the power minus j omega T naught into X omega. Okay. State that means XT minus T naught means shifted by some time constant T naught of the original signal XT. So X T minus T naught minus T naught is equal to e to the power minus j omega T naught X omega. E to the power minus j omega T naught into X omega, where X omega is your Fourier transform of XT. X omega. Okay. So the same signal XT, if shifted by XT plus T naught, then we can write the Fourier transform equal to e to the power j omega T naught X omega. You know, so XT minus T plus T naught as the Fourier transform of as the Fourier transform is equal to e to the power j omega T naught X omega. Is it not? So X T plus T naught T plus T naught is equal to e to the power j omega e to the power j omega T naught into X omega T naught. Into X omega. Okay. Now we just try to prove this property. That means X T minus T naught equal to e to the power j omega T naught X omega. Okay. So how we can prove this property? Let's try to see here. Proof. Of this property okay. That means we know that the Fourier transform of XT is represented by integration from minus infinity to infinity XT e to the power j omega T dt. Okay, so just write here the standard formula of the Fourier transform of any signal XT. So in some Fourier transform of any signal XT is represented by Fourier transform of any signal xt is represented by integration from minus infinity to infinity xt e to the power minus j omega t dt. Note. So just write here the standard formula of Fourier transform xt. So x t equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity from minus infinity to infinity xt e to the power minus j omega t dt. Xt e to the power minus j omega t dt. E to the power minus j omega t dt. Omega t dt. So Fourier transform of x t equal to minus infinity to infinity x t e to the power minus j omega t dt. Now we just try to put here xt equal to. So xt equal to we have xt minus t naught, is not. So this value put here in place of xt. Okay. So Fourier transform of xt minus t naught. So Fourier transform of xt minus t naught xt minus t naught equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity integration from minus infinity to infinity to the value of xt minus t naught in place of xt. T naught is a constant values, constant value either maybe 3, 5, 8. So xt minus t naught t naught into e to the power minus j omega t dt. E to the power minus j omega t dt omega t dt. Is not. So now if you consider here t minus t equal to some another time period, that means a. Okay, so let we consider let us consider t minus t naught equal to a, which is another time constant, means t minus t naught equal to a, right? Not so t minus t naught equal to a. Now if you differentiate this equation with respect to time, so how you can write this one dt, this is your constant value, so this becomes a zero, and this one is your time variable, time period, so this one new time period, so this one represented a da. Okay, so if you differentiate, then we can write here dt equal to dt minus, sorry, minus zero. This one is your constant value t naught. So differentiation of this constant value is zero equal to dA. Is not? That means dt equal to, you can replace dA. So dt equal to dA. Is not? Now if this consideration we put in this equation, that means x Fourier transform of x t minus t naught equal to here, then just we try to simplify this equation. So Fourier transform of x t minus t naught, Fourier transform of x t minus t naught equal to x t minus t naught, t minus t naught equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity you can write here x a, is it not? In place of t minus t naught, we consider a. So we can write here x a e to the power minus j omega t. So from this equation, we can write the value of t equal to a plus t naught, you know. So just put here the value of t equal to e to the power minus j omega into t equal to a plus t naught, you know. So omega into a plus t naught, in place of dt, we can write dA. So just here dA. Now, if you simplify this equation, that means e to the power minus j omega a into e to the power minus j omega t naught. Can we write here, na? So just simplify this equation and write this exponential terms in separate form. That means e to the power minus j omega a into e to the power minus j omega t naught. So Fourier transform of x t minus t naught. Fourier transform of x t minus t naught equal to right here x t minus t naught equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity x t minus t naught equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity x a into e to the power minus j omega a into e to the power minus j omega a minus j omega a into e to the power minus j omega t naught e to the power minus j omega t naught omega t naught into dA. Okay, so this e to the power minus j omega t naught is your constant value, can be taken outside from this integration, is it not? If this constant value e to the power minus j omega t naught, then it can be written from outside of this integration. Okay, so its Fourier transform becomes Fourier transform of x t minus t naught can be written as x t minus t naught can be written as e to the power minus j omega t naught, because this is a constant value. So e to the power minus j omega t naught into integration from minus infinity to infinity x a e to the power minus j omega a dA. Minus infinity to infinity एक्स ए टू द पावर माइनस जे ओमेगा ए डी एक्स ए इंटू ई टू द पावर माइनस जे ओमेगा ए इंटू डी ए टू द पावर माइनस जे ओमेगा ए इंटू डी ए So, if you compare this equation, that means minus infinity to integration from minus infinity to infinity x a to the power minus j omega a dA, then we can write the Fourier transform of x omega, because we can write the Fourier transform of x t equal to minus infinity to infinity x t, that is represented by here. You may be write as that is also written as equal to x omega, is it not? So if you compare this equation, equation number may be considered as one. And if you consider this is your equation number two, equation number two, then we can write the value of integration from minus infinity to infinity x a e to the power minus j omega a dA equal to x omega. Here, in place of t. Time period here x is your due time period. Okay, so this can be written as Fourier transform of x omega, is it not? So if we compare equation number one, equation number one, and equation number two, is not equation number one. And equation number two. So we can write Fourier transform of x t minus t naught equal to e to the power minus j omega t naught to x omega, is not? So Fourier transform of x t minus t naught can be written as e to the power minus j omega t naught into x omega. So x t minus t naught minus t naught equal to e to the power minus j omega t naught into x omega. Good. So e to the power minus j omega t naught t naught into x omega. X omega. So this is proof of xt Fourier transform of xt minus t naught equal to e to the power minus j omega t naught x omega. Similarly, we can prove here xt plus t naught equal to e to the power j omega t naught x omega t naught. So similarly, we can write here Fourier transform of xt plus t naught equal to Fourier transform of xt plus t naught so x t plus t naught so that means Fourier transform of xt plus t naught equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity xt plus t naught into e to the power minus j omega t dt x t plus t naught into e to the power minus j omega t dt e to the power minus j omega t dt. Power j omega t dt dt. Now again we consider here t plus t naught equal to a, it's another constant, so right here t plus t naught equal to a, let us consider t plus t naught equal to a. T plus t naught equal to a. Same things here. T naught is your constant value, and if you write here t equal to a minus t naught, t equal to a minus t naught, t naught. So if you integrate this, differentiate this equation, you can write here dt equal to dA. And again, t naught is your constant, so this differentiation is becomes zero. So dt equal to dA. If you put this consideration in this equation, so we can write here Fourier transform of Fourier transform of xt plus t naught equal to x omega equal to x t plus t naught equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity minus infinity to infinity x a into e to the power minus j omega in place of t we can write a minus t naught x a into e to the power minus j omega omega into a minus t naught a minus t naught into in place of dt can we write as da just put here now again you write in the separate form of this exponential e to the power minus j omega a into e to the power minus minus plus j omega t naught t naught so right here the Fourier transform of x t plus t naught equal to x t plus t naught equal to this term is your constant that means e to the power minus minus plus j omega t naught so this term can be taken from the outside of the integration so you can write here e to the power j omega t naught j omega t naught integration from minus infinity to infinity integration from minus infinity to infinity x a e to the power minus j omega a good so x a e to the power minus j omega a da to the power minus j omega a into da okay so this value is equal to nothing but x omega that is Fourier transform of x a is not so the Fourier transform of x t plus t naught and we retain as e to the power j omega t naught into x omega. Okay. So this is equal to nothing but e to the power j omega t naught j omega t naught into x omega. X omega. So this is also proof here. That means x t plus t naught as the Fourier transform is equal to nothing but e to the power j omega t naught x omega. So you can directly put the Fourier property of some problem based on the time shifting property of the Fourier transform, where x t equal to, if you know that x omega, that means Fourier transform, then x t plus t naught equal to e to the power j omega t naught. Okay. So we stop here, and in the next class we will discuss another property.